هيا على الفلاح.
السلام عليكم. If you think that your color, race, your nationality, your tribe, your part of the world is better than others and they are inferior because of that, then you cannot be a true believer. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, warns us and he says that people are all equal and the only virtue is the piety or connection with your maker, which is known only by the maker himself. So nobody should ever think for a moment that they are better than another race, another nationality, another part of the world, another village, and so on. My brothers and sisters, I know we might claim that we don't believe that, and we might claim we are not racist, but look deep down. There is always room for improvement. Either way, no matter who, no matter where, no matter what, there is always room for improvement. So don't treat people badly based on their color, based on their race, their nationality. This is something that a lot of Muslims actually need to rectify or work on, because there is a lot of racism, tribalism, whatever other ism that there is within the Muslim communities. And people do sometimes believe that they are better, their nationality is somehow superior in the eyes of Allah than another. A'udhu billah, may Allah forbid. Remember, that is jahiliyyah. It is worse than the period of ignorance. There is no hierarchy in Islam, not at all. Sometimes people use this as an excuse not to marry. They use it as an excuse not to do business. They use it as an excuse to talk badly to. They use it as an excuse to refer in a derogatory manner to another race, another nationality. Like I say, sometimes even another part of the same country. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. I thought it would be very important to speak about this. Do you know, if you understand the maker and if you really love the maker, you would love everything that maker has made, everything connected to that maker, you would respect it to say the least. So even if there are other creatures that you may not like, you need to make sure you respect them and you treat them fairly the way Allah wants you to treat them. Don't ever let this ignorance creep into your heart or mind that makes you feel that for some reason you are more entitled, you are better, superior, and so on. That is absolutely unacceptable and totally untrue. As believers, even our prayers are not accepted if in the rows that we stand in the houses of Allah or the masajid, we discriminate against people. The Hajj and the other acts of worship, if we were to discriminate against anyone based on their social standing, based on their color, their nationality, and so on, the fact that they might be financially disadvantaged, if we were to discriminate on those lines, our acts of worship would not be accepted, or the reward would be nullified or reduced. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. Like I said, work on it. Work on it hard. No matter who they are, where they are from, we all have the exact access, equal access to Allah Almighty, and all of us are equal. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, La fadla li arabiyyin ala ajami, wala li ajamiyyin ala arabi, wala li abyadha ala aswad illa bittaqwa. There is no virtue of an Arab over a non-Arab. Surprising he said that, but that's exactly what he said. And there is no virtue of a non-Arab over an Arab, or a white over a black, except by piety, which is only known by the Almighty himself. So stop it. My brothers and sisters, don't maltreat people or look at them with an eye of skepticism or with an eye that maltreats them or judges them wrongly. If you want to think of people, think good of them, or protect yourself from harm and harming them and harming yourself by thinking bad or negative thoughts about others. You know, it could have been the other way around. And that is so, so wrong. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, strengthen us, and make us from those who really can respect everyone. Yes, People will be slightly different in their culture. They will be different in their habits. They may be different slightly in the way they speak, the way they come across, the languages they use. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about it in the Quran. Do you know what he says?
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ
In Surah Al-Hujurat, Allah says, O people, I have created you from a single male and a female, ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى, and from the two of them, we created you into various tribes and peoples, different clans and different, you know, races, etc., in order that you recognize one another. Just to recognize one another, to be able to identify each other. So Allah created every human different for identification purposes. Your iris, your thumbprint, and so many other differences, it's for you to be recognized. Imagine if everyone was exactly the same, life would be so boring. But Allah says, we made you different colors and sizes and shapes and nationalities, or in fact races and so on. At that time, nationalities was not really applicable, but my brothers and sisters, guess what Allah says? إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ Indeed, the most honored in the eyes of Allah is the one who has the best relationship with Allah. And indeed, who knows that? The very, very end of that verse, Allah says, Inna Allaha Alimun Khabir. Allah is the one who's all-knowing. He is the one who knows absolutely everything. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us true believers. True believers. If Allah is special in your heart, anything that He made should be special in your heart. Because if it's not special, you need to realize that you haven't understood Allah. Why would He make everything else with you in order for the test to go ahead? Do you maltreat them or do you respect every single person? أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Thank you so much for listening to the short message. I pray that it has increased you in a little bit of motivation and hope. And the same applies to all of us. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.